In this video, I will show you how to share your streamer room with others. First, I will create a new account, and then I will use my admin account to give it permission to use one of my private and secure rooms. Let's get started. To create a new account, go to www.streamer.center. Streamer remembers your last login, so when you go to the site, you may be automatically logged into your admin account. If that's the case, then exit by clicking on the sign out button here. Now, I'll click on the login button. Here's where a person can enter their account name and password. And if they have forgotten their password, they can click on this link to have a reset link emailed to them. In this case, I want to create a new account, so I'll click on the Create One option, like this. I can now enter the information for the new account. There are two types of accounts I can create: a personal account that a specific person will use to log into Streamer, or a guest account that many people will use all at the same time. An example of where you would use a guest account is if you are captioning a live stream of a presentation, or people in an auditorium are listening to a presentation that you are giving. Everyone listening can log in using the same shared guest account. This makes it very easy to provide closed captioning to a large group of people, perhaps in a church service or a remote learning classroom. The steps for creating a personal account or a shared account are identical, but the usage permissions are different. Later in this video, I'll show you this difference. In this case, I'm creating an individual account for Sarah Harris, an employee that works at our company. So I'll type her name into a box like this. Note that an account name cannot have any spaces in it, so I used a dot between her first and last name. If I were creating a shared account, then I'd name it something like Avante-Guest. The email address is only used if Sarah forgets her password. This is the email where a reset link will get sent. I'll then select the default language for the new account. This can be changed later. For Sarah, I will select US English. The preferred voice is what will be used when you are translating your speech into another language, and also if you are nonverbal and you will be using Streamer to speak for you. Don't worry too much about this selection. It can be easily changed later. In this case, I'll just pick Joanna. And here is where I'll enter the password. Passwords need to be at least 8 characters long, and they are case sensitive. Then I'll click the Register button and accept the terms and conditions, and the new account has now been created. Here's what the lobby looks like for this new account. Notice that they only have access to the public and open demo room. That's it. I want to give Sarah permission to use our company's streamer room, so I'll do that now. I'll sign out of the new account that I just created for Sarah and log back in using my admin account. Then I'll jump into the room that I want Sarah to use, and I'll type the allow command, like this. Notice that each command in Streamer starts with a forward slash, and each account name starts with the at symbol. These are special characters that let Streamer know you are entering a command and an account name, versus words that should be entered into the transcript. Well, that's it. That's all you need to do to let someone use your private room. When Sarah logs into her account, she will now see this room in her lobby. I'll show you that now. I'm going to resize this window and open a different browser to log into Sarah's account. I'm using Chrome for my admin account, and I'll use Microsoft Edge for Sarah's account. I'm using two different browsers just so you can see both accounts at the same time. So again, my admin account is here on the left, and Sarah's personal account is here on the right. Notice that Sarah now has permission to use the room. It's showing in her lobby. So to review, I created the new account for Sarah, and then using my admin account, I jumped into the room I want to share with her, and I typed the allow command. If you ever want to see a list of all the accounts that have access to your room, use the allowed command like this. This shows you a list of everyone that can use the room. If you want to remove that permission, you can use the unallow command. Remember, with Streamer, you as the admin control all the access and usage permissions for your rooms, such as their ability to download transcripts. We've combined the most commonly used sets of permissions into two groups, which we call super users and normal users. Right now, Sarah's account is set to be a super user. A normal user does not have as many usage permissions as a super user. One key difference is the microphone and command bar at the bottom of the screen. To show you that difference, I'll make Sarah's account a normal user. To do that, in my admin account, I'll enter the make normal command. Sarah's screen refreshes, and when I go back into the room, you can see the microphone and command bar have now been removed. This means she can just view the captioning. Whatever she says will not be included in the transcript. With a normal account, she cannot change her password, the language that is being used, or the name of her account. If you are setting up a shared account where you only want people to be able to view the captioning, such as a live stream of a webinar or captioning a church service, then you will most likely want to use this make normal command. Since this is a personal account for my friend Sarah, I want to caption what she is saying. So I'm going to turn her back into a super user. I do that using the make super command, like this. Here are some additional permissions you may want to grant a person. The set download command gives the person the ability to save a copy of the transcript. In this case, I want to let Sarah do that, so I use the command like this. Note that with the set download command, specifying the user account is optional. If I type set download yes, then everyone that enters the room can download that transcript. Or if I type set download no, then no one except me will be able to do that. The set clear command gives the person the ability to clear the transcript. I want Sarah to have that ability, so I'll type the command like this. Again, I could also choose to not enter an account name, and then the setting applies to everyone that can access the room. And in this case, I'll also make Sarah an owner of the room. This means she will have the ability to invite others to join her in the room. To make her an owner, I'll use the add owner command. All the commands are shown to you in the online help menu, which you can view by clicking on the icon here. You can also download a printable copy of the manual by going to this address. Well, that completes this video. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us, and we'll be glad to help.